I awoke. Feverish and barely conscious, I set to drawing these maps through the sable hours. By morning, my fingers ached, my eyes burned, yet still I found no rest. The reverie commanded its rendering. The reverie device now stands completed. I've placed the first of my maps within its receptacle. I've taken my maiden voyage into nightmare. I know now that which sent me this precious gift. It knows me, expects my return. It would be foolish to disappoint. Malachi. Fingertips brushed the cool, silken planes of that fast gem. I felt it. My skull ached as if its contents were growing, pressing against the bone, searching for a way to break free. That night, once the wine had dulled the pain enough to allow the onset of sleep, the dreams began. I have not been without them since, nor would I be. Every spark of thaumaturgy that I wield, every device that I forge, every creature that I transfigure, I owe to these lessons cloaked in nightmare. From whence do these precepts hail? Certainly not the mundane grey between my ears. I possess only one reference that bears faith. Translated with unquestionable clarity by that idiot savant, Isius Pirandus, the beast. Duryani of the Vow knew the truth. Soon now, so shall I, Malachi.
beneath the summer sun, we followed Tarkus in search of the promised land. Before long, hunger grips our steps. The Doomlands take their toll. Our numbers dwindle, and discord spreads among us. Russo's words quell our hearts, but not our stomachs. It's all right, Exile.
The Monkey King names you slave. No, you are the gems of Rayclast, not the treacherous stones you dig and die for. It is time to bend the Monkey King's ear. Tell him your true name.
there's a familiar face. Before you say anything, yes, I did try to kill you. Inexcusable. I allowed pragmatism to overcome honor in a moment of desperation. Please accept my deepest apologies. And what do you say? Can the two of us make a fresh start? Marvelous! Now, as you've clearly noticed, the Allflame has given me another respite from oblivion. Alas, it's a partial success only. I am neither man nor spirit, living nor dead. A state that comes with some rather frustrating restrictions. I know we've only just been reacquainted, but to put no finer point on it, I need your help. Interested, are we? Oh, splendid! In return, I have a gift or two that I may bestow upon you with a click of my translucent fingers. All you need do is furnish me with a crystal decanter and a juicy piece of fruit. Two humble items that remain agonizingly out of reach for a man in my peculiar situation. Will you look at that? The decanter spiritus. As exquisite today as when I found it all those years ago. You may fault the man, but you can't fault his craftsmanship. I'm sure you've heard of Malachi by now. Ever the heterodox, he sought otherworldly inspiration by imbibing a substance called ghost wine. For the purpose, he created the decanter spiritus. I found it on my last visit here. Liquid placed in this crystal decanter becomes quasi-apparitional in nature. I'm sure you can glean the decanter's usefulness to me. Conventional liquids simply don't hit the spot. I am one sorely parched revenant. I hid the decanter spiritus in the marketplace so as not to cause temptation for the less morally steadfast in my crew. Look to the carven heraldry there and find a lion dancing upon the waves. Emperor Chittus was stabbed in the posterior by his own Lord Mayor on the eve of the Purity Rebellion. Chittus's grieving gemlings buried him in the Imperial Gardens, and a plum tree was planted upon his resting place, so that his mourners might taste of his glory for years to come. I found that tree, and one of my men tasted its fruit. I've never seen so much agony crammed into such a brief moment. This may seem a peculiar request, but please bring me one of Chittus's plums. This current form comes with rather frustrating restrictions. It's a small improvement on my last incarnation, but I'm a man who used to poke his sticky beak into the furthest corners of the world. Now I can barely cross the road. It was no mean feat getting here from Siren's Cove, I can tell you. So here's the truth of it. I intend to sup upon mine own death. Oh, fear not. The Allflame will resurrect me and, with luck, will restore my full freedom. But for that to happen, I must die. And in such a manner as to excite the Allflame to utmost ferocity. I am convinced that only the fruit of Chittus can provide a demise of sufficient tragedy. Life is full of painful choices, is it not? I visited Sarn some 30-odd years ago. Those ghasts, the undying, you call them, scurried up from the sewers near the river and slaughtered all but a few of my most stalwart lads. Oh, they're a foul parody of humanity, those undying.
Nothing in common with a fine, upstanding revenant like myself. Greetings, exile.
What's going on?
Bring me back something nice, huh?
Yes? How can I help?
You have thormetic sulfite? You are a resourceful unbug now, aren't you? Give it to me. I was all eyes and ears when Malachi worked. I know exactly what to do. A dash of arcanity, a pinch of insanity, a whisper of profanity, and the infernal talc is now ready. The most explosive of powders. A sprinkle, the gentlest of dustings of infernal talc will provoke gems to a molten rage. For the undying, the very sun will rise within their flesh. They will burn for their sins, not a cockroach. They will burn. Goodbye. Hello, not a cockroach. I said...
Greetings.
Oh.
The Gem Genteel are an infestation. They are the Monkey King's fleas that drink of your lifeblood. Crush them in your work-forged hands.
Please, somebody help me! I've fallen down here! I think I've hurt my leg! Hello? I'm sure someone will come soon. Oh, I'm so hungry. If I get desperate, maybe I can eat some mushrooms.
I cannot carry this.
What's up?
Bring me back something nice, huh?
You've forgotten your place, Karui slave.
God, who do you fight for, exile?
I cannot carry this.
What's going on?
You've done for Gravisius. If only I could get word to that lad I smuggled away from the general's wife at the time. The good widow would need a sympathetic shoulder to cry on.
You are the true spirit of the Makoru, the shark. Not the cowardly beast that sinks its teeth into the lonely swimmer. You strike the Waikoama, the canoe, spilling a feast of men into the water. Hunters turned hunted, that you dine on at your pleasure. Have this, Makoru.
Grigor straddles two worlds. One foot planted on this soil, one in the dirt of spirit and shadow. When you speak with him, be sure to know from which world his words arise. There's still prey out there. An overreaching witch floundering out of her depth. Happy hunting, Makoru.
Something? You find a high enough spot and you can see the Lunaris temple over the river, at the western edge of the city. Since the blackguards arrived, the clouds above that temple have been stained with the blackest of smoke. You can see it sometimes when the westerly blows. It stinks worse than death. Gravisius dined with us once. This was before my father's gambling debts caught up with him. I dined with him again in Theopolis prison the night before my exile. He wasn't so polite that time. Thank you. That's one memory I can now put to rest. Be careful.
The Gemling Queen? She's impossible. How did she survive? Why is she not one of the undying? No, these questions can wait. There's a more pressing one. Is she safe from the Ebony Legion? You've been busy. With the spool back where it belongs, the ribbons should be able to keep the Ebony Legion at bay. We've both seen what they can do to a man. Whether you were saving your own skin or thinking of others, it matters little to me. You succeeded where I did not. You have stood in the presence of the Gemling Queen. I can only hope to meet her in my nightmares. Despite everything else you've done, to let piety live is to threaten the existence of every living thing on this continent. Look to the west of Gravisius's camp. You'll find piety in the Lunaris Temple, cowering behind her desecrations. The Eternals revered sun and moon as the two eyes of their god. The right eye, judging Solaris. The left eye, merciful Lunaris. I can't imagine that god being overly merciful when she finds out what piety's been doing in her temple. Have fun elsewhere.
My legs ache, but at last they can rest. We have 2 days' journey from the nearest city. The trickle of water sets me at ease.
Return.
Begin to set up camp.
I cannot carry this. I cannot carry this.
You looking sharp?
Welcome. The Plague Maw enters the Red Realm and leaves a swirling mess of living stone.
I cannot carry this.
How you doing?
Don't do anything I would.
enters the Red Realm and leaves a swirling mess of living stone.
I cannot carry this.
Yes. I was a good man. I fought for God. I remember saying so. That symbol, the Descry, it stirs my half-remembered blood to think of it. I wanted to do good things, important things. Can you imagine finding the truth of oneself on the wrong side of morality? I have thought long on this fearful notion. But now I know exile, and that relieves me. I am no longer afraid to recover more of my memories.
Mate.
Don't do anything I would.
Welcome. The old Red Ones left this land barren. Crops grew stunted and disease filled the air. If you don't feed an animal, it will soon cast a hungry eye upon its brothers and sisters, and man is no different. The Plague Maw and his people soon feasted on their own, devouring the very life essence of the young and innocent.
I cannot carry this.
Hello?
Don't do anything I would.
I cannot carry this.
How you doing?
Bring me back something nice, eh?
Piety, you are truly Kitava's slave, a daughter of corruption.
Thank you.
Please, somebody help me! I've fallen down here! I think I've hurt my leg! Hello? Stay calm. I'm sure someone will come soon. I'm so hungry. I get desperate. Maybe I can eat some mushrooms down here.
I cannot carry this.
What's up?
Hello. A fool tries to turn lead to gold, but a deft hand takes it by force.
I cannot carry this.
A hand scrawls on a wall, or carves into bone, a tale that undoes the world and teaches those who come after.
Stay out of the shadows. They bite. Get in there.
Don't do anything I would.
You've done your ancestors proud, Karu. Now, here's your warrior's death. You'll be remembered, Karui. Damn you!
I will take everything Dominus loves as he took it from me.
Piety's off to meet the Maker, is she? I'd love to be a fly on the wall of that little chat.
Don't do anything I would.
You have claimed the most worthy of prey, Makoru. Piety, the mistress of corruption. I'm not saying the war is over, but you've given Rayclast a much-needed respite. Because of you, this land lives to see another dawn. And don't forget that you've done Grigor and Clarissa a justice of some magnitude. They will wish to speak to you. Citizens of the Sand that was, the Undyne have been around for hundreds of years. Left to their own devices, they'll likely survive for hundreds more. Still, they're not immune to mortality's touch. They can be killed with some difficulty.
Do I know you? Do I know you?
Wherever he is, I'm sure Tolman knows what you've done. I know you didn't do it for him, or for me. It doesn't matter. Piety's reign of cruelty is over. Thank you.
Piety dies amongst her abominations, her warped dream taunting her, maddeningly out of reach. As a poet, I'm fond of that creed of justice. Here, the executioner needs recompense. Unfortunately, Piety was simply a puppet of a greater force. You've cut the strings, but the master remains. Dominus. That key you've picked up, I heard the blackguards talk of it. It's the one key to the Scepter of God on the northern edge of the blackguard encampment. Only Piety was permitted to carry it. Dominus accessed his laboratory at the summit of the tower via a pulley system rigged to the outside wall. That way will be barred to you. And I heard of no one, not even Piety, going in or coming out of the lower levels. Go with care, Exile. I can't imagine what's inside that tower if even Piety and Dominus feared to tread its steps.
When Piety was experimenting on me, my consciousness was mercifully fleeting. In those moments of numbing darkness, I met a presence. Intelligence, power, immensity beyond the limits of my pitiable mortal senses. To this creature, I was but a raindrop falling into the sea. I heard Piety speak to her lackeys of the beast. It is the source of her thaumaturgy and the object of her ambitions. I believe Piety's beast and that dark entity are one and the same. Wherever it is, whatever it is, the beast is the cause of my malformation. It would not be a stretch of reason to consider the beast the source of all malformation in Rayclast. Now you must leave.
forgotten your place, Karui slave. Let me remind you.
I fought for God. Who do you
thank you.
leader cannot simply stride forward into the future
rolls on a
and
wall,
expect his people
or
to be
carves
able
into
to
bone,
follow.
A tale a that undoes the world
over
and teaches those
so
who
so that
come
he can
after.
Witness and understand the consequences of the path he has chosen. To ensure that his people are still with him, to ensure... A leader cannot simply stride forward into the future and expect his people to be able to follow. A leader must look over his shoulder so that he can witness and understand the consequences of the path he has chosen. To ensure that his people are still with him, to ensure that he has not become lost. The Karui do not hide in towers built of fear.
I'm a fool to have gotten lost here. But it was getting dark, and I thought I saw a way home. A crowd stands silently around me, their faces blank white, their bodies covered in ropes.
Thank you.
It's all right, Exile. Oh.
Don't do anything I would.
Look at the sheen on that plum.
Is it not the most delectable fruit that you've ever seen?
No.
Perhaps the gloss of hope is for my eyes only. Wondrous! Nothing bonds two souls more soundly than murder. For that reason alone, I knew you could be relied upon. Now, for a little amateur vintnering. A quick squeeze of the plum like so into the decanter. Oh my! Look how it transmutes the juice so swiftly, from material to spectral. Effortless.
And what an aroma. Imminent death never smelled so sweet. I believe I shall call this fine concoction the Imperial Nightcap. Now, before I get too carried away, there's the small matter of your recompense.
Toast!
to swift endings and promising new beginnings. Oh, and you might want to avert your gaze once I have quaffed this diabolical brew. I doubt that my return to solidarity will be a pretty one. Right. As I used to say in the love dens of Trafus, bottoms up, girls! Oh, my. Now that's an unusual sensation. Oh, dear. Something's amiss. The Allflame, it's... No! No, 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 it's gone out! What am I... You cannot be. I will not.
To live too long is to live in pain.
Hello. Guidance is priced in silver. If the price is not...
There you go.
Yes.
Carry this. I cannot carry this.
Hello? Good luck to you.
I cannot carry this.
Come over here.
Bring me back something nice, eh?
My dear Chittas, the Empire has lived in fear and ignorance since its inception. Our Asmiri ancestors, in their arrogance, turned their backs on the lessons of the Vaal. The emperors before you lacked courage, lacked vision, paying lip service to eternity while scrabbling for approval and comfort within the prison of their meager mortal lives. You are not one of those emperors. You are Chittas the Great, the man who will make this empire truly understand the meaning of the word eternal. We shall build this thaumatocracy together, my emperor, gem by gem, immortal by immortal. Your devoted servant, Malachi.
Thank you. Though we were worlds apart before, exile has brought us together. Back in Aureoth, there were those that referred to me as the Wonder Child. But as you've likely discovered, titles mean little here. Wonder, exile, monster, hero. It's not the name that defines you. It's what you do that makes you what you are in Rayclast. Thank you. You have given me what matters most. The freedom to finish what I started. Though we were worlds apart before,
exiled an animal. Now you almost resemble a man. Thank you.
You have mounted the summit of the Empire, not a cockroach. You have crushed the Bug Emperor and wiped his maggot dreams from the skin of Rayclast. Dominus exiled you, naked and alone, unto the palm of death. But you would not die, would you? No. No! You cuddled death, promised it the world, made it your conquest, and so generously shared it with all your fleeting friends here in Rayclast. Not once did you forget what you were. Not a cockroach feeding on the corpse of a dead empire, like the pests you crushed as you walked. A man. The sort of man that planted the seed of this empire right here in Sarn so long ago. What teetering and twisted life it still holds dear. This land owes to you, Marauder. Of course, there will be more. You know that, don't you? Emperors. Avaricious little pests scrabbling to steal the legacy of their betters. Unless we burn that legacy, sear its infection from the flesh of existence. Go north, my lovely Unbug. Go to Highgate, to the beginning of the end. Dive headlong into the Nightmare Sea. Catch and roast yourself a nice big fishy. What do you want?
Follow a dead river to the foot of Kitava's kingdom. Just how the elders at home told it. To Kitava. It is time to hunt!
Ah!
not worry, little beast. We are friends now.
I cannot carry this.
Why won't you let me leave? I found you so many yellow rocks. This pick is getting dull, and I'm so tired.
I cannot carry this.
Mate.
To kill a man like Dominus. That's an accomplishment worthy of Kaum, my greatest ancestor. Were we in Na Makanui, I'd make you a Makanga, an honored warrior. But we are not in Na Makanui. We dwell in a city of death, and my respect is all the honor I can bestow on you. You have claimed the most worthy of prey, Makoru. Piety and Dominus, the harbingers of nightmare. I'm not saying the war is over, but you've given Rayclast a much-needed respite. Because of you, this land lives to see another dawn.
We opened the gates to you for two reasons only. Dominus and Piety. They made themselves our enemies. You made them dead. Now, Oyan believes there is a third reason. The beast is our enemy. Perhaps you can make it dead as well. The Maraketh and the Karui have fought side by side in the past. And side by side, we were lied to and used. History must not be allowed to repeat. Let us share only the truth, Marauder, so that we may wipe our memories clean. Oyan has ordered me to help you, to trade with you. I have risked much to gather weapons and armor for this Akara. I've scavenged on the fringes of Vol's encampment and scouted the dead city. Let us see if you can offer any value in return.
Do I know you?